evening. My name is Fred Hartnett. I live in 680 Lydia Avenue in the city. I have two issues I'd like to bring up here this evening. First is to the folks from the power plant, both power plant. I have to be honest and say, as time has gone on, from my perspective, things have not gotten clearer. They've gotten more cluttered. One of the concerns I have is that in the ninth inning, you guys come up with a new technological plan as to how you're going to use water. My question to you is this. Is this proposal, is it being used elsewhere? Are you going to recycle water rather than taking water directly from us on a much larger capacity? And if so, where is it being used? My second issue is directed to the council through you, Mr. President. And that is, I have a concern as to whether if we sell portable water to the town of Fargo, do we become a public utility for Fargo as we are, for example, in North Smithfield, where the PUC has determined since, you recall back when there was an issue with Dolly Village, and the city tried to block the use of water, you were unable to because you were determined to be a public utility by the state of Rhode Island. If that's the case, then sort of all bets are off. In other words, if somebody else was in a Barrowville and wants to put up some other kind of an operation, and you are considered a public utility by the state of Rhode Island, then you're going to have to provide water. If they decide that that's the water that they're looking for now is not enough, you can have all the agreements in the world. In my opinion, the state will concede that and force you to give them additional water. So we need to get that answer from the PUC as to whether or not, if you provide them potable water, whether it's by pipeline or by truck, whether you become a public utility for that community and you are therefore bound to provide water to them for whatever reason. Those are my questions. I applaud the city council for its due diligence, and I am a believer in the old adage that it's not the history you make that counts, it's the history you know. You got to look back and say, we sold water to North Smithfield because we had to. And what did it cost us? Lowe's, Walmart, other businesses that left because there was no traffic up in that area, including Sears leaving as well. Let's not repeat the issue. Let's not do the wrong thing. Let's not sell the water. Thank you.